life is purposeless. Now what does that mean? What does that mean? Pay attention to this. Because this remains a contentious thing for a very large number of students. We are not prepared to understand this or look at it, what is meant by the fundamental purposeness of life. When do we call something purposeful? When it results into something, right? When it results into something. And when the result is more important than the process itself, correct? Then we can say that something is purpose-driven, that there was this purpose to this activity. Right? Getting it? The purpose remains, the thing becomes immaterial then. All of us know one fundamental thing, that right since the day we were born, the journey towards death has begun. Correct? As far as this body goes, you have already lived around a third or a quarter of your life. अगर आपको जीने के लिए 3 दिन दिए गए थे तो एक तो आपने बिता दिया, 2 और बचे हैं. All of us will end up, if it is a question of where we end up, what is the target of life, all of us will end up in only one place. Either in a grave or in a crematorium. तो अगर आप कहें कि पर्पस क्या है जिए जाने का, तो पर्पस तो एक ही है कि जल जाना, खत्म हो जाना. क्योंकि पर्पस का अर्थ ही वही होता है जो अंत में आए. जब कोई एक्टिविटी पूरे करते जाओ तो उसके अंत में जो हो वो उसका पर्पस कहलाता है, कि मैं इस उद्देश्य के लिए कर रहा था, आखिरी चीज. ठीक है ना? तो जहां तक जीवन का सवाल है, उसमें तो आखिरी चीज मौत ही होनी है, राइट? एंड आफ्टर यू डाई आर यू देयर टू लुक एट whatever you have so called achieved or whatever. मरने के बाद कितने लोग लौट के आएंगे कि मैंने कितनी बड़ी बड़ी बिल्डिंग बनाई या कितने मेडल जीते या कितनी ट्रॉफियां इकट्ठा करी. The nature of life is that once gone you are gone. Once gone you are gone. And this enough is evidence that there cannot be a purpose, an end result to life. If there thing is anything about life, it is living itself. If at all you are very eager to say that life must have a purpose, then that purpose is living itself. And when do we live? When are we living? When are we living? When are we living? We are living right now. We are living right now. So if you are very eager that life must have a purpose, then that purpose is to live. And to live means to live right now. You are not living in the past and you are not living in the future, right? You are living right now, here, this place, this very moment. So if you must say that life has a purpose, that purpose is this. This is the purpose. Otherwise, there is no purpose. How can there be a purpose? Existentialists say that, you know, we are like a chicken running with its head cut off. Just the time span is different. The chicken will run for a while and we know it will run only for 30 seconds or so and then it will collapse. Similarly, the day we are born, our head is cut off, we run for 70 or 80 years or so and then we fall off. You cut off a chicken's head, it will run for 15 seconds, 20 seconds, and then it will collapse. And a baby is born, it will run around for 70 years or 80 years or so, and then it will collapse. So difference is only in time span. We are condemned to be not to be here. We are condemned to not to be here. What is the purpose? What can be the purpose of a chicken with its head cut off in running around? Can there be a purpose? No. Similarly, there is a beautiful animation flick, just 3 or 4 minutes long. Look for it on YouTube. you'll enjoy it, called Fallen. Called Fallen. So it shows that
cartoon
from some other planet or an asteroid, a piece of rock starts falling towards Earth. It knows that it is falling, and it's molten rock, very hot. It knows it is falling, and that soon its life will end. Initially, it is very, very scared. Very scared. But then, as it travels a little distance, it starts enjoying. Then enters the Earth's atmosphere. It meets the clouds. It meets the birds, and as it is meeting them, it is constantly moving towards its death. It is constantly moving more and more rapidly towards its death. In fact, its velocity is accelerating. But now it has started enjoying it. And by the time it reaches the surface of Earth and hits the ocean, hitting the ocean means its death, because it is a piece of molten rock. The moment it hits water, it is gone. By the time it hits the surface of the ocean, it has lived its life fully and completely. It is smiling. And as it sinks into the ocean, even in death, there is a beautiful smile on its face. Now, what is the purpose of this rock falling from that asteroid or that planet and meeting its end? There is no purpose to it. If there is anything, there is this journey, there is this movement, and the learning that is happening in the course of this movement. But we are so obsessed with the purpose, and all purposes are for the future. Remember, when you say I have a purpose, that purpose always lies in the future. But we are so obsessed with purposes that we stop living altogether. Living is gone, purpose is in. Purpose is in, living is out. Who has the time, the space, the botheration to think about purpose if this moment is joyful? If I am complete and joyful and loving in this moment, who has the time to bother about purposes? Why would I do that? To be thinking about purpose is to be not to be present right now, is to miss out on life. Yes, ma'am. Others? I know that coming from where we are and having been conditioned for as long as we are, for as long as we have been, it will be difficult for you to understand what I've just said. But let it stay with you. Let it just stay. Do not be in a hurry to accept or reject.